Hey everyone, welcome back to Integrative Psychonautics. I hope you're doing well out there. So today's video is a bit of a share of my own personal content that I've been developing here, which is a couple key concepts, a couple key metaphors or frames that I'd love to share with you to help you better understand what the process of working with your nervous system to help regulate it, what the process of healing and personal transformation and therapeutic growth and using psychedelics looks like, especially in the beginning. So the two concepts I'm going to share with you today are a couple that I've been developing and I find myself continually using over and over and over with each client to help them more clearly understand what it is that we're up to. And since I know psychedelic therapy and transformational change and nervous system regulation, these are kind of concepts that are vague and broad or big and complex and confusing, I thought these would be really useful kind of models of understanding to share with you guys to help you understand better maybe what the first steps are here on your path of healing. So if that interests you, let's talk about it. And just really quick, before we go ahead and get into the content, which I'm psyched to share with you, please do me a favor and help the channel grow here. I'm a terrible self-promoter. And so if you can do your part to help me grow the channel, either by linking and sharing to someone else who you think might appreciate this video, or by, you know, giving a thumbs up if you resonate with the content here, if you really like my delivery, my style, my way of thinking, please consider subscribing to the channel, all that kind of good stuff. It would mean the world to me. Okay, enough said, let's go ahead and talk about these two frameworks of understanding. Okay, so I don't really want to be too redundant here because I already set up a pretty clear understanding in the introduction of what we're going to be talking about. But yeah, basically, long story short, I find myself, you know, always kind of tinkering on thinking about how to better explain and describe this complex process of healing, personal growth, personal transformation, nervous system regulation, trauma healing, trauma release, psychedelic therapy, how that all fits together, what are we up to, especially when a client is kind of new to me and maybe new to any of this work altogether. I'm always thinking, how can I explain this more clearly? How can I kind of leverage first principles thinking to convey a very simple way of understanding what it is that we're up to here and why it's relevant, why it's important? And so this is what's going on in the background for me personally as a coach, as a hypnotherapist, someone working with people all the time, right? And you know, so I'm always coming up with kind of like new ways of thinking about this or different vantage points. And I've arrived at a couple metaphors that may seem a little counterintuitive, or you might be like, really at first, but these have been really useful ways to help people understand more deeply the process that we're really up to here. And so I thought I'd just share them with you guys because I want you to kind of have a clearer, better understanding of if you're going to be using psychedelics to heal, what that looks like and what's going on. And, you know, even separating out the psychedelic part of things, because the psychedelics are just really there to aid in the process of transformational growth and transformational healing. What is at the beginning steps, the beginning of this road of transformational healing? What are the things we need to really understand about what we're up to and what needs to be in place to do this, especially if we come from like a background of, you know, real trauma, like really heavy duty stuff that we really need to heal, or a lot of anxiety or a lot of triggers or something like that? What do we need to know? You know, so this is what I want to explain to you guys here in this video. And without further ado, let's go ahead and just dive into the first of these two, really what they are is metaphors that, you know, as a hypnotherapist, I'm always thinking of metaphors. So lo and behold, I'm going to give you two metaphors here that hopefully will be useful tools for what you're up to. Okay, so let's get into it. Okay, so the first metaphor that I want to convey to you here is the concept of range of motion, that what we're up to here when it comes to trauma healing, trauma resolution, you know, nervous system regulation, psychedelic therapy, personal transformation, a big part of what defines having the issue we have is that we have a very narrow range of motion with our nervous system. So you can kind of think of it, you know, very much as if you have lived your life with an arm sling or a cast on for your entire life, and, you know, or since you were very, very young, and now you're a full-grown adult, and now you suddenly got your cast off, or you're getting your cast off, and your ability to, you know, extend your arm all the way is very limited, and it feels very alien and weird and foreign to extend your arm all the way, right? This is very much a parallel to what it's like to develop your nervous system capacity and to really start to work on self-regulation, really start to work on expanding your ability to feel and to feel different states and to feel different moods and to process different types of emotions and to kind of self-heal and self-regulate and self-parent. It really is an expansion of your capacity to move. And I'd love to offer you kind of implicitly in this concept, I think this is really true. This is not my idea. This is something I had taken in from my trainings, that the healthier the person, kind of the wider the range of capabilities, right? The more flexible your nervous system is, the more, in other words, you're able to be solid and self-regulated in moments of challenge or stress. The more you're able to, be open and vulnerable and soft, or strong and resilient and powerful and assertive, the more you're able to, look at things from different points of view and shift your way of feeling and relating to something, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. The more flexibility you have in your brain and body and nervous system, generally speaking, that's going to correlate with more mental health, emotional health, and a sense of well-being, right? And there are a lot of different, ways that we go about this in the work, especially when we're using the medicine to, help a person expand the capacity and discover new kind of dimensions of, opening and unfolding ourselves, right? So there's a lot to that in terms of the how and what do we do to increase that range of motion. But essentially what we're doing is reclaiming ability to feel, ability to access data and information in our body, in our nervous system, reclaiming our ability to think about or see situations in new ways, in different ways, and in general to become more adaptive, more curious, more nuanced, more intentional and conscious, more self-attuned and attuned to others, right? So there's a whole set of things that go inside of this range of motion concept, but I want you to just kind of get the idea that what we're working at is helping you to really stretch yourself out and open up your capacity for new ways of, let's say, being, right? And this is key. This is a huge part of healing and a huge part of growth, right? So especially in the beginning, clients typically come to me and this is one of the major things they need. They have a very kind of small box that they've kind of cornered, that they've boxed themselves into neurologically, and a very small palette of emotions that they feel, and a very small set of thought loops that they tend to return to over and over and over. And a very, it becomes this very narrow, confining way of experiencing life. And that's really painful and overwhelming and disappointing and challenging, and one of the huge gifts of psychedelics is that they can really take you outside of that box that, of our nervous system that we've known it to be, and that we've kind of perhaps confuse that for how life really is. And they can really take us outside of that and give us this whole other experience and give us very visceral embodied proof that we can feel a different way, that we can see things in different ways, and that life is so much more than what we thought it was. So that's metaphor number one, expanding your range of motion. This is really a good thing. Generally speaking, when it comes to nervous system flexibility, I don't know if you can be too flexible. The more adaptive and flexible you are, probably the healthier and better and happier your life experience is going to be. So that's metaphor one. Okay, and the second metaphor here is basically strengthening the container of your nervous system, right? So you'll notice in both of these metaphors, I'm really talking about how to work with our nervous system, because that is the fundamental underlying thing that we're up to here in order to help you heal, in order to help you transform, in order to help you feel a different way in your skin or have a new experience of life, in order for you to kind of authentically and comfortably create transformation that invites new behaviors and new ways of seeing and new ways of operating. Really what's at the foundation of this, right, is working with your nervous system and learning how to modulate that, how to shift that, how to open that up and transform that or rebalance that if it's out of balance, right? And so the other way of thinking about this is really strengthening the container. And by container here, I do mean your nervous system. I do mean your kind of observer self, your kind of higher self, your kind of inner parent, if you want to think of it this way. the wise holder, the wise observer of all the different phenomena of narratives and emotions and reactions and memories and fears and different nervous system states that happen inside of you, right? So if you think about it, there is a fundamental relationship here, which is the you that is the bigger container, the bigger intelligence, the bigger awareness, the bigger wholeness. And then inside of that larger you, there are all these different layers and facets and sides of your personality. If you want to think of it in terms of like parts work and IFS, we could call these parts, or we could just call these, you know, different dimensions or different narratives or different, you know, currents of emotion, if you want to think of it that way, that exists inside of us, right? And fundamentally, for most of us, what we experience is that these, you know, these layers and facets and currents and narratives are loud and intense and strong and overwhelming and confusing and challenging and painful and all the things, right? And that's really what's present for us. And we are very unaware of our container self, of our nervous system, of our body, of the larger kind of observer, friendly, attuned, patient, you know, presence inside of us that can sit there and witness and be present with and connected to all the different layers of stuff, right? And so it's really this broader container self that we want to strengthen and we want to really be in touch with and have access to easily, because it's this relationship between your container self, your kind of wholeness, your bigger, larger, deeper, broader, you know, the whole you. It's really about the relationship of that and the parts or the layers or the emotions or the narratives or however you want to think of it. And this is so, so important, right? So if you have a very underdeveloped container, these emotions are going to overwhelm you. You're going to get hijacked constantly by fears and triggers and different competing narratives inside of you. You know, what if you have a fear to do one thing and a fear to do the other thing? How do you resolve that kind of stuff? And all that kind of can really chew you up and stress you out and overwhelm you and make you disheartened and really feel like you have so much on your plate. And I get it. I've been there. I work with clients every week, every day, you know, that are dealing with this kind of stuff. So I'm intimately familiar with that fear and that sense of overwhelm. I see it all the time. So the move there, if that's all really loud for you, if that's all really big for you, is of course to develop a really healthy, strong sense of container of your nervous system so that you have more of a capacity to hold and contain and work with and relate to all these different things happening inside of you without them necessarily hijacking you. All right. So this is often the first kind of real round of work is when I'm working with someone. This is a lot of what we're up to here, is strengthening that container consciousness so that we can comfortably and safely hold whatever it is that needs to be reprocessed or expressed or felt or remembered or understood, right? So without that, the proposal, the notion of I'm going to go process all this traumatic stuff I've been through seems very scary and very daunting. But when people have a really clear felt sense of, oh, I can hold this. I can do this. I can be present with this stuff, the fear, the shame, the guilt, the angst, the anger, the terror, the confusion, the whatever it is, you know, the stuff that needs care and tending to and working with and processing. If I have a sense I can hold that inside of myself without it totally overwhelming me, it makes whatever deep work I need to do so much more doable, right? And so this is one of these things that a lot of folks who are new to psychedelics don't really think about, don't really consider, that makes all the difference. And, you know, ideally in a perfect world, A, we get a feel for that and we develop a strong sense of container, right? But then B, you know, we can start to work to actually grow and expand that container to tolerate even bigger, even more powerful, even more, you know, deep, intense, whatever it is, you know, or joyful, profoundly positive emotions without that overwhelming us too, right? So the other part of the work is not just getting solid, but then stretching and expanding our capacity to hold more and more. Ultimately, the people I know who are really good at that, can really deal with a lot of stuff without it totally hijacking them and overwhelming them. And, you know, for anyone who's curious about the therapist side of psychedelic therapy and, you know, the trainings and what's required to be good at, you know, medicine work with people, it is this container consciousness that is a huge part of what is required to actually be good to work with people. You've got to be able to not only, you know, hold space for the other person and all their trauma and all their stuff, but also in case anything of yours gets stirred up or kicked up, you've got to be able to hold space for that too, to be able to really hold this solid container while the other person maybe can't yet, right? So these are both key life skills, right? So, you know, whether we're talking about gaining that range of motion back, and that might look like reclaiming your joy or reclaiming your love of being in the body, or, you know, being honest about your emotions, et cetera, et cetera. And then, you know, really developing this strong container that can really help you to be present and safely process whatever it is that needs safe processing. When these are there, you know, it makes the rest of the work so much easier, so much smoother, so much safer, so much, quite frankly, like, not that it's necessarily fun to deal with some of the stuff, but it makes it more fun. It makes it more doable and sometimes even profound and beautiful, right? But also, these are life skills. These are things that I think, if I'm going to be brutally honest here, to be a well-developed, well-rounded, well-functioning, secure adult human being. These are two fundamental life skills you want to have here. So yeah, let me just kind of add a couple comments here about, you know, what I see typically, and then we'll kind of wrap the video. So you might be wondering, do you need this, right? Is this something that you need to do? Who needs this? Who am I talking about when I'm kind of mentioning this stuff? So, you know, this is in general things that I'm looking for as a coach when I'm, you know, interacting with a new person who potentially wants to work with me and they talk to me about what it is they want to work on. This is one of the things I'm considering in the background. How well developed is their ability to kind of hold certain strong states of emotion, you know, and how much of a range of emotion, you know, and range of motion do they have in their nervous system? Generally, I'm saying this more for the people who really, you know, if you're someone who has a lot of trauma healing work to do, if you're someone who hasn't done a lot of therapeutic work or a lot of, transformational work with yourself, this is something you're probably going to want to work on. If you're someone who tends to get hijacked, if you're someone who tends to be totally numb and over intellectualize everything, and, you know, your way of going into a felt sense of safety is to kind of avoid all this stuff altogether, and you're not used to being confronted by stuff. If you're someone who, you know, tends to have really big emotions, and, you know, or you're someone who's really terrified, but you feel like you need to heal, this would be where I would go first with you, right? So this is less so where I would go for someone who maybe is a little more high functioning, a little more already doing okay, and maybe they want support around maybe making a major life decision or getting clear about something from their past, or they're doing some work healing themselves and kind of letting go of stuff, but they generally kind of, you know, have that capability in place already. This is going to be less relevant for a person like that. So it really depends for me personally on who this is appropriate for, client to client. But for a lot of the clients that come to me who are like, you know, I really need help organizing, understanding of where to go, how to do this work, and, you know, what's really going to be healing for me. And I need a sense of safety here. You know, I don't feel safe in my own skin. I'm easily triggered. This kind of a thing, this would be probably where I'm going to take a client like that. So hopefully that helps you to understand better the relevance here. This isn't necessarily for everyone, but these are deeply important, and I think really make the work doable. You know, if I'm going to be honest here, what I see when I look at other kind of people working in the psychedelic space, kind of talking about their work, whether these are, you know, guides or kind of, you know, leaning towards shamanism, or even, you know, some therapists who are new to psychedelic therapy and are really coming from a certain kind of therapeutic paradigm of, you know, catharsis and deep emotional processing, and maybe are undereducated in like somatic therapy and stuff like that. I see a certain kind of stripe of psychedelic therapist out there who really puts speed first over like slowing down and building up this capacity for safety before the person starts really engaging the difficult stuff. You know, and this isn't to say that while we're doing this work that I don't help people to also process things. We certainly do, but we're kind of like, we're dancing back and forth between processing and working on stuff and helping the person to understand what it is to hold that in themselves and relate to that and be a container for that and what it feels like to work through something and regain a little more range of motion in their nervous system versus avoiding that or just getting sucked into it and kind of in a spiral of overwhelm over and over. So I hope that makes sense. I hope this is a useful set of tools for you guys. I'd love to know, what do you think of these ideas? Does this resonate? Does this land for you? Does this hit home as I get it? This makes sense and I can see why that's useful. I'd love to know because right now I'm just talking to a camera all by myself and these are just the things that make sense to me. So anyways, if you would do me a favor, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of this. That'd mean the world to me. And I have more content on the way for you guys shortly. Much appreciation for all of you guys. I'm really just so grateful for my audience. And I'm so excited to share all the rest of the stuff I have to share with you. There's so much on the way here. So anyways, big love to you. I hope you're doing well out there. Of course, if you have any questions, if you want my feedback or thoughts or anything like that, or if you're thinking about working with me, my email is down below in the description of the video here. Do reach out. I'm always happy to talk to people. I'm very helpful. I'm very generous. All right, much love to you. I'll talk to you soon. Take care.